In today's exercise, we will examine the maintenance procedures for our pipe cleaning powerhouse, the Gopher GO-MP9 rotating nozzle. The GO-MP9 is rated up to 22,000 PSI and is designed to clean straight pipes from 2 to 6 inches in diameter. It also adapts to larger pipes with the use of a centralizer, as shown here. This model can handle flows up to 25 gallons per minute and features 4 interchangeable, self-rotating heads. The heads are jetted for high and low flow rates, as well as unplugger and polisher configurations. Each one is comprised of a 4-jet head, collar, body, inlet nut, and port screw. The inlet nut features a high-pressure seal stack-up for connecting to medium-pressure supply lines. Before we get started, let's look at the tools required for your Gopher maintenance. You'll need an adjustable wrench, snap ring pliers, a pick, a 9/64-inch hex wrench, slot screwdrivers, a ballpoint pen, blue goop anti-seize, and grease. Begin disassembly by placing the tool in a vise with the inlet nut facing up. With an adjustable wrench on the collar flats, loosen the head from the body. Continue to unscrew the body by hand. Set the head aside. Now flip the tool and secure in the vise using the flats on the inlet nut. With a pick, remove the first O-ring from the tip of the shaft. It is a standard O-ring, rounded on the edges, and always sits on top. The second O-ring is a backup, with a flat edge on one side and concave on the other for receiving the standard one on top. We'll review this again when reassembling. Loosen the collar halves with a 9/64-inch hex wrench and set aside. Loosen and remove the port screw with a slot screwdriver. Next, remove the seal stack-up from the inlet nut. Start this process by removing the O-ring that holds the stack-up in place. With that removed, the stack-up will usually drop out of the inlet by itself, but you may need to tap it gently to coax it out. With the stack-up out, you can further disassemble the parts. Start by using a pick to remove the O-ring from the inlet seat. Next, remove the carbide seat and high-pressure seal from the seal holder. These are all wear items, so set them aside for replacement with parts from your service kit. Now we'll return to the vise. Secure the tool using the wrench flats on the inlet nut. Loosen the body with an adjustable wrench. Note the wrench is on the flats for the body. When loose, remove the tool from the vise and continue to unscrew the body by hand. Motor oil may drain out at this point. This is to be expected. With the inlet nut off, note the shaft seal inside and the O-ring at the base of the threads. You can now slide the remaining shaft assembly out of the body. Note the shaft seal at the base of the body. We'll remove that in a moment as well. Next, remove the top bearing ring from the shaft and the shim beneath it. The shim has a flat side and a chamfer side. The chamfer side faces down toward the weight set in this assembly. Now slide the brass sleeve off the body. Remove the first spring in from the notch in the weight set. Remove the weight set and set it aside. The second spring end attaches to the hole in the shaft. Use your pick again and with the spring disconnected, slide it off the shaft and set aside. Remove the last bearing ring from the shaft. Note this bearing ring has a wider inner race that faces the shoulder on the shaft. We'll remind you when reassembling later. Finally, remove the shaft seals from the body and inlet nut. Modified snap ring pliers will assist with this step. When the shaft seals are out, your last step is to remove the O-ring from the base of the inlet nut threads. Your disassembly is now complete. Wash all parts and examine them for damage or wear. These are the wear items and they are all contained in your service kit, including O-rings, a high-pressure seat and seal, and a port screw. With your new replacement parts, begin the reassembly process at the press where you will install the shaft seals. When installing these seals, we recommend using P80 Grip-It or a similar lubricant. Start with the inlet nut. Place the new shaft seal on the MT-105 spacer tool with the lip side facing up. Apply lubricant and press the seal into place. Replace the O-ring at the base of the threads and set the inlet nut aside. Now place the shaft seal on the RJ105 spacer tool, lubricate it with P80 Grip-It, and press it into the body, this time with the lip side facing down. We're through at the press, so let's head back to the vise. Begin by taking the RJ007 bearing ring and place it on the bottom end of the shaft. This bearing has the wider inner race that faces the shoulder on the shaft. Next, reconnect the weight set, spring, and the shaft. Insert the first spring end into the hole in the weight set and slide them both onto the shaft. Now connect the second spring end by rotating it into the hole in the shaft as shown. Note the action when the spring is assembled correctly. Slide the brass sleeve over the shaft assembly. The shim goes on next. Note the chamfer side is down here, facing the weight set. The BC009 bearing ring goes on next. Both sides of this ring are identical, so it doesn't matter which side faces up. With the shaft assembly complete, you are ready to remount it into the body. Start by generously greasing the shaft seal in the end of the body. Now slide the shaft in. At this point, you are ready to fill the body with motor oil. Secure in the vise with the head end down. As you fill the body with oil, twist the shaft at the bottom to allow the oil to settle into the tool. Continue filling and twisting until the oil reaches the bottom and starts to drain out the port. This helps remove air from the body of the tool. When this draining occurs, replace the port screw and continue filling until oil covers the top bearing ring as shown. Keep spinning the shaft to ensure that all the air bubbles up and out. Now grease the shaft seal in the inlet nut and apply blue goop to the threads. Screw the inlet nut back into the body and tighten with an adjustable wrench. Note the vise is on the body flats and the wrench is on the inlet nut flats. You are now ready to rebuild the seal stack up that goes inside the inlet nut. Begin by placing the O-ring into the groove in the inlet seat. Next, grease the high pressure seal and place it in the seal holder, far enough to leave a 1/16 inch recess as shown. Place the carbide seat in that recess, with the chamfer side facing up. Now grease the O-ring generously. Now stack the seal holder on top of the inlet seat in preparation for loading it into the inlet nut. We recommend using a ballpoint pen or pencil to feed the stack up into the inlet as shown. When the stack up is properly inside, flip the body and install the O-ring that keeps the stack up in place. You may need a pick to make sure the O-ring is nestled into the groove. Now it's time to burp the oil inside the body. To do this, place the tool in the vise with the inlet end facing down. Using a slot screwdriver, carefully loosen the port screw just enough so any remaining air escapes from the port as shown. Retighten the port screw. With the tool still in the vise, replace the collar halves on the shaft. Tighten the screws with a 9/64-inch hex wrench. Make certain the two halves are tightened evenly so the gap is the same on both sides. Now replace the two O-rings on the tip of the shaft. The backup ring goes on first, making sure the flat edge is on the bottom and the concave side faces up to receive the second O-ring. Place that O-ring on next, on top of the backup as shown. Finally, replace the head on the shaft. Start by greasing the O-rings on the shaft tip and apply blue goop anti-seize to the threads. Screw on the head. Tighten with an adjustable wrench. Your GO-MP9 reassembly is now complete. Before we wrap things up, let's look at the tool and maintenance kits available from StoneAge. We recommend having one or more of these kits on hand for easy field maintenance, and we further recommend using all the replacement parts to make the most of your downtime. These are the spacer tools that come in the GO-612 toolkit, the MT-105, and the RJ-105. They are handy for replacing the shaft seals in the body and the inlet nut as you saw during reassembly. This is the GO-600 service kit with replacement parts for routine maintenance. It contains written instructions, O-rings, a high-pressure seat and seal, port screw, anti-seize, motor oil, and a syringe applicator. The GO-610 overhaul kit contains more items when it's necessary for a major rebuild. You'll find written instructions, anti-seize, a port screw, shaft seals, shim, O-rings, high-pressure seat and seal, seal holder, bearing rings, a spring, brass sleeve, and motor oil. That's it. Thanks for watching, and remember, our technical specialists are always on hand to answer any questions or repair issues you may have.